And we are back with our film critic, Jim Hunter. Last week, I told this to Jim, I saw an article on my Facebook feed. It was the story of a lawsuit filed on behalf of Scarlett Johansson, and it seems she and her management are fired up, Jim, regarding a contractual agreement about Black Widow. So I thought perhaps you could explain what the rub is, as they say in Shakespeare.
Sure. I mean, yeah, this is a huge story within film criticism and the film community. It is Scarlett Johansson suing Disney over, quote, breach of contract. She alleges that the contract that she signed for Black Widow included a theatrical exclusivity. So that means that Black Widow would only be released in theaters, and that after releasing Black Widow in theaters, it would stay in theaters for, according to the lawsuit, 90 to 120 days, which according to the lawsuit, lawsuit is industry standard. She is absolutely right about all of those things before 2020. The COVID-19 pandemic has altered the theatrical landscape, and as a result of that, Disney did a day and date release of Black Widow. That is, it appeared on Disney Plus at the same time that it appeared in theaters. Johansson alleges that as a result of that, that affected the box office grosses. And we actually have a graphic of the Black Widow grosses by week.
Let's see if we
can show this. Yeah. $80 million in the first weekend.
Wow.
That is, well, yeah, like that is a great opening for most MCU films. That's comparable to Doctor Strange. It's comparable to Spider-Man Far From Home. But look at that drop off. 80 million to 25 million is a 68% drop off. That's almost unheard of.
Can we claim it then that it's the simultaneous release of this film?
Yes, that is what Disney in some of its press releases touting Black Widow's success on Disney Plus. Disney stated before the lawsuit that Black Widow grossed $60 million on just from the Disney Plus release. So Johansson's contract is structured that she gets a share of those box office totals that we just showed you, but she does not get a share of the Disney Plus release. So Disney is making all of that money, $60 million in the first weekend, according to its own press release, and Johansson's getting none of that. Now, I know that when millionaires sue billionaires, it's hard to have much emotional attachment to this thing.
But yet.
It is a case of where Scarlett Johansson and other stars like her, including Emma Stone, Gerard Butler, who are both, Gerard Butler did file a lawsuit. Emma Stone is reportedly contemplating filing a lawsuit because a lot of these studios are not releasing their streaming numbers and they're not sharing their streaming numbers with creators.
So, okay, this is going to be a legal battle that is a developing story, as we say here.
It is.
Because if you're a manager and if you're an agent and you're a lawyer for these people, you're going to be writing other contracts with different language that says whatever's happening in streaming and what's happening at the box office, my people get a piece.
Exactly.
There's a lot of hands in that pot, that big money pot, Jim.
There absolutely are. For Disney's part, they are saying that Johansson is showing a callous disregard. That is a direct quote from their statement. Callous disregard in face of the COVID-19 pandemic. But that is pretty rich coming from a company that also laid off 32,000 people during the COVID-19 pandemic.
Thank you for putting it in perspective. Jim Hunter, we'll be back with more Lifestyles right after this. Stay with us.